The Syrian Observatory for Human Rights is saying that the Syrian government deliberately targeted a bridge over the Orontes River very close to the border with Lebanon. This particular crossing point was often used by residents trying to flee the violence, especially that in the town of Qusair and the city of Homs, one of the hardest hit in the government's most recent crackdown. This particular bridge, not only critical for those trying to flee, but also one of the main routes used by activists to bring in much-needed food and medical supplies. Activists say that they believe that the government is deliberately trying to inflict as much damage and pain upon them as possible. Meanwhile, the United Nations is saying that at least 2,000 Syrians fled the violence, crossing into Lebanon over the weekend, adding to the thousands already inside this particular country, many of them struggling, having to seek refuge amongst various Lebanese families crowded into very small rooms. A lot of activists based in Lebanon are in fact urging the UN and the Lebanese government to set up some sort of permanent refugee camp, believing that the crisis inside Syria is not going to end anytime soon. Meanwhile, Valerie Amos, the UN Undersecretary General for Humanitarian Affairs, set to arrive in Damascus on Wednesday, supposed to meet with the Foreign Minister Walid Maalem and visit a number of areas, although at this stage it is unclear if she will be able to reach those most in need. And many activists say that these types of moves, though welcome, are only buying the Syrian government even more time. Arwa Damon, CNN, Beirut.